Alright, if you're just joining now, I'm just waiting for some stuff to finish up and then I'll be going fully live. I'm also waiting to get into one of the servers right now. They're all full. It's a pretty popular mode that I'm going to be streaming today, so hopefully we can get into one. Turn the camera back on in a minute. I just gotta do some stuff really quick. Like, put pants on. It's always a good one. Was it not showing the game? Ooh, that's fun. Okay, so I probably gotta do some stuff here. This is the perfect time to use my tech support banner. Perfect. Actually, I know exactly what's happening here. See that top left there where it says main menu? It's thinking that's the game. So give me a second and I will fix that. Gotta love those default window sounds. Why didn't it go away? I thought I turned it off. Okay. So here's my like current car. It's not the right color. It keeps going red for some reason. So I have the custom color set up for it. It's like a half gloss, I don't know. It's good stuff. Got a bunch of stuff set up now for the stream, for like when people follow and do all that kind of stuff, so now that I have the time to, I should focus more on actually streaming, especially since I do stuff like this. Anyways, so let's start off. I'll sort of go over everything that that goes into this. So this car is sort of built up now. It's got uptuned engine. This isn't the right config actually. I can actually just show you it this way. So you see this Moonhawk turd? That's the vehicle you get when you buy it on this server. So like every time you want to buy a vehicle, you have here, I'll just show you. Okay, so you start with the Piccolina, right? It's a piece of crap. It doesn't have shocks, it doesn't have like anything. No brakes in the back, it's really, really bad. And you have to like do missions, get the money, buy the parts, make the car actually drivable so that you can make more money, and then you can get the next car. And just like it says here, you have to like, there's like a tier list to it, so you can't just rush something really good with the Pico unless you buy the car before it first. So like for example, I have the Burnside, the Covet, which I haven't modified at all, I haven't touched it because it was the cheapest one out of these three, and I really wanted this one because the Moonhawk wasn't on the server like a month ago until they did an update to it. And the Moonhawk's my favorite car, so basically I had to have it. I don't really care about any of these cars. I'd get the ETK, whatever it's called, the coupe. And then I don't really care about the French car or the SBR. I'd get the Bolide, but it's like, the Bastion's pretty cool. I'd get either the van or the truck anyways. The Roamer and the Wendover, they're kind of like whatever. Also, am I talking too quiet? There's stuff going on behind me, so I'm trying to like keep it down a little bit until that's over. But I'm still gonna drive around and stuff. Yeah, so basically I got the Burnside so that I could generate the money to get the Moonhawk, and now I'm kind of done with this tier list. It's kind of like, if you really want a specific car, or like a couple of specific cars, and eventually I know the T-Series is going to be here, and truck, so I should probably flesh out this anyways, get the Bastion, or the ETK 800, but I'd probably get the Bastion, because Dodge Charger, you know, gotta live up. So let me show you what you get when you buy any car. This is what you get. Actual garbage that can't carry anything. Like it has 4 cargo slots. And for example, my one that I'm about to load has 27. So like you get a really crappy thing to start with, and you have to put money into it to make it better. I don't know. I really like the dynamic of it. It's cool to me. So sue me. That's my nice one. I don't know why it loaded up my like another version of it. Yeah, let's get the colors on there. And I want to get a roll cage for it, for the version I have for the Jungle Rock Island map, because it actually rolls over a lot and crushes the roof, and it sucks. But I also want to get another car. Like, I want to get the Blue Buck or the Grand Marshal. So I don't know. Probably the Blue Buck, though, because it's just cooler. Yeah, engine's like pretty maxed out. Except it's naturally aspirated. It makes like 600 horsepower and 550 torque, or like the backwards of that, something like that. I don't remember. It's really fast though. Let me actually reload the UI. It's really rough, but it's also really awesome. So here, now you can actually see the prices for everything and sort of how that all plays in. Like 11 grand for the big V8 engine when you start with the 6-cylinder, right? So the better the car is, the more expensive, like the more money you have to put in it. It all scales. It works. I mean, it's like it's as grindy as anything else. Like I could just be playing War Thunder instead, but I don't know. This is fun. I can't use my wheel with War Thunder, so It's not really fun to use your HOTAS with War Thunder, so I'm just shit talking War Thunder and I shouldn't do that. I do like War Thunder. I don't have it installed though. Alright, so now you sort of get the elevator crackhead pitch for this. Now I'm actually gonna do some stuff in it and try not to crash and actually make it look cool. Because as much as this game is about crashing, it's expensive to crash in this. And you can actually like lose enough money to the point where you kind of have to go back to your really crappy cars because you don't have the money to repair your nice ones. It's cool, I like it. And it's getting more fleshed out as time goes on. Like, you know, it's an early version of a game mode for a multiplayer mod for an alpha game. It's, you know, but it works. Rough around the edges, but it works. And actually, there's one stupid thing I have to disable, which I think it's just like a multiplayer mod bug. I don't think it happens in the vanilla version of the game, but there's this weird filter that makes the steering wheel work less as you get faster to get, I guess, sort of simulate how the wheel gets stiffer as you go faster, but it just feels weird with force feedback, so I don't know why it exists. So we're just gonna do that. And it doesn't save. For some reason, every time I launch the game, or if I get like disconnected from the server, I have to do that again. So that's fun. But now that it works, listen. This will work. That's the entire point. That's the freaking motto. That's what we care about. Oh, look at this guy. I don't even know what car that is. I don't care. We're gonna do our own thing and be a menace. Oh shit. So I said everything works smoothly and it's just a little rough. It's like, it's BeamNG, so it's rough. But once it's set up, it's set up. Dude, technology is so awesome. I love how reliable and functional it always is at all times. Did I even post that I was streaming? I should probably do that. Oops. There. I'm allowed to have tech issues. Oh, you? Dang. That's gonna be fun. Gotta love working for the man. Now that I've actually posted that I'm streaming. Hi. Yeah? Am I allowed? You just were a little bit. Now I can Casio. Now I can play the game. After 3 years. 45 minutes late, the stream is starting. I'm gonna move this so it's not in my way. Awesome. So there's two main ways. I think I said this last time. I stream, but it's, I don't know, in case anyone who's watching for some fucked reason. There's two main ways to make money by doing the deliveries, and that's by, like I explained earlier, carrying more cargo or delivering the stuff really fast and getting a bonus for delivering it fast. And that's kind of where the two tier lists come in. You can see that one of them is sort of more focused on carrying heavier stuff, and the other one's more focused on going faster, which unlocks in the going faster one. So also just like kind of helps because you see it fading and you know someone's coming and you kind of know to just like that, you know. And it's great because there's like 8 other people on the server doing the exact same thing. They're all trying to get their nice car, or like get their cars nicer. Race tracking your stands. Oh shit. GPS is a little inaccurate, so it kind of leads you to the wrong place sometimes. You kind of gotta learn where the locations are by name, and then actually pay attention when you get them. That was planned. So was that. Yeah, so there you see, $239 time bonus, and that's even with me fumbling it at the start. Now that dude with the trailer, he spent the money to get a pro license for his car, which I think for this car it's like 11 grand. So I could get it and then pull trailers, which it does give you a little bit more money, but then you also have to deal with a trailer being behind you, and sometimes you get a trailer that's been loaded like as improperly as possible, like all the weight is behind the wheels so that it throws you off. It's just, it's suffering. Which is the idea behind it. Oh, that was suffering too. Oh, that's gonna be worse. You didn't see that. That didn't happen. Since you're on the inside of the car, you can't actually see that the car is broken. That's the genius of my... I could repair it right here on the road, but that's really expensive, so it makes more sense for me to try to limp it over to the garage that's right here. I can. How bad is it? Oh, that's not good at all. actually $95. It would have been like probably closer to $1,000 if I did it outside of this green circle. With its stupid ladders and pipes. What would you do if you saw this thing just rolling up behind you at twice the speed limit? I should put the bash guard on my city one. Like I said, I have an adventure one, which is like, it's lifted and it's got off-road tires and shit. But it's still four-wheel drive, so it can't really go anywhere. But it's better than nothing. Better than this on race slicks. Casio. We have to kill her, I think. Probably could have done that faster by not following the GPS. I see. Probably grab gas before doing this next one, but I'd rather be irresponsible. So, weight savings, bro. See, look, watch, this is gonna be way faster. Usually the deliveries are a little bit longer than this. I don't know why it's going to be such short missions. Also, refueling in BeamNG, what else does that besides, like, I think this truck mod? Oh, I see it. How do we get to it though? Probably like this. If I hit it hard enough, I'd probably do. We're not gonna cheat. Use node driver. Clearly, I just need to come in a little faster. Ooh, not at those rocks. Almost works, I'll do it again. My suspension looks really fucked. Oh no, I'm just like... Okay. Just like Clarkson, use the log as your parking brake. I really don't want to have to hit it steeper because I'm gonna fuck up my car. I'm probably gonna have to. I didn't need that. Now I have better ground clearance anyways. Try from the other side. Also, I clearly have an oil leak. Aw, it looks a lot less steep from this side. I'm dumb. Thank you. Okay. Okay, so now I know what the strat is. I must hit here with speed. That's not speed. This would be a lot easier if I just didn't have race tires on, but they make everything else so much easier. Here. How are there 9 out of 8 players? Uh-oh. It's the Popo. They won't catch me ever. So it's all good. I don't think there are any, like, road laws anyways. There's no real cops. Just like in Mexico, those fake cops, you know, they're fake because they got nice shoes. Poor runners.
Wrong button. Brian Bouton.
And that was like a little less expensive, like $200 for a printer. Oh, you guys won't see this because it's in the corner where my face is, but there's food that I can pick from, and I'm now eating it. Ice cream. In the middle of the mission, I don't get the time bonus anymore, so now I gotta race against the clock and the oil pan leaking out. Thank you. stairs. I'm just gonna make this a little higher up, I think. Or just pull out my adventure one. It's pretty much tuned exactly like this is, but shitting me, damn it. I thought I would be able to take those jumps. Thank you.
typical that as soon as I pull this out, I get no missions oriented towards it.
I should have filled up my race point. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, I lose the time bonus anyways.
Because I made a compact. EA Sports. It's in the game. How did that happen? We will never know. Whoops. Huh. Alright, and with that broken drive shaft, I think I'm gonna call it for now. Go make some lunch or something. No, I guess dinner. Thank you to anyone who joined me today. I might stream a little bit more later. Maybe some Pavlov, maybe some, I don't know, some H3? King Spray? We'll see. Car borked. Alright, see y'all next time.